good. Another case closed, another bottle open. Huzzah to Valeria!
Hang on a tick. I recognize that face. You were talking to Yanis after I left the temple. I'll bet she's put you up to something.
Yes, she did. Afraid so, I found new evidence. She asked me to find Lorgan's real killer, seeing as you can't be bothered. Man, that's sassy as hell. Alright.
Why must you busybodies insist on interrupting a perfectly good night? I know that look. You remind me of Devella. Fine! If you doubt my conclusions, out with it. What have you found?
How is an elephant talking? Like, who's Devella? Right. Father Lorgan's murder is just one part of a bigger plot. Man, I can actually say I spoke to both corpses. Okay.
That doesn't make sense. Why would this dwarf kill Father Lorgan? I need something more than vague allegations.
What the fuck do you mean?
Compelling, hard, tangible evidence.
Like,
nothing.
I literally asked the damn bodies. Like, it's like asking the guy who got killed, like, hey, who killed you? It was a dwarf. It's like, how is that not good enough? Father Lorgan's murder is... Alright. A group of shapeshifting assassins were under the temple along with more murder victims.
While that is startling, it still doesn't disprove my theory that Brilgor killed Father Lorgan. Does it? That's what you need if you want to change my mind. Hard evidence. A reason, too, if you're at it. Why was Lorgan killed? A Baal plot. You as well.
Are you fucking serious?
About Baal for months. Fancies herself something of an expert. I assumed it was just a bunch of conspiracy codswallop and fear-mongering. But she's been unusually insistent about this one, even for her.
I didn't find the murder weapon, did I?
Bite. What's your theory?
I mean, what is my theory? It's not a theory. I have proof. This document contains information connecting the murders to the Bali's resurgence, you dipshit. Like, if that's not enough, I will fucking murder you, alright?
No need to wave documents at me. I'm already drowning in paperwork as it is. Constable Devella is going to be a real pain in the trunk about this. Since you seem to be on an obnoxiously similar wavelength, why don't you seek her out? She'll be at the Elf Song Tavern. Show her the list, and I'll stay and inform the Fist here. Oh, and you'll need this pass.
Oh, nice.
It'll give you access to the Lower City.
I didn't have it before. My man is still drinking.
Well, what are you waiting for? You've a bloody conspiracy to solve. Move!
Isn't that your job? Like, I wish I could kiss you. Man, I hate this detective.
I mean, to try.
Well, at least I have a lower pass city, lower city pass city. Where is he going? He's going upstairs. And this place is filled with random people. At least I can't talk to any of them.
Tim, seems like a lot.
Do you not wish to pleasure your fine maiden? To fill her fingers with yours in pure ecstasy?
Huh?
I'm not doing anything. I mean, good day to you.
Ah, yes. The most innocent man in Baldur's Gate.
If you are in need of some pleasurable assistance, might I direct you to Sharess's Caress? I only deal with referrals.
I mean, sure. Let's just go back in again. Not like anything out here, is there? Alright, open the den. Door, let me in. Alright, so I want to see what this place is about.
When the music stops, you and I, we will continue dancing. A new face. Looking for another chapter of dirty lore for your
biography? Wait, are these the two drows?
But to ask, and we can grant you a moment of pleasure.
Ah, fuck, I thought it was like two chicks. Not a dude. How did you end it here? How do you end up here?
I used to work as a courtesan back home, and my sister as an artisanal masseuse.
Sister? But
men are treated like dogs by the Underdark's matriarchs, so we fled.
We found surfaces craved the body of a drow like a drug. Life is easy in our line of work.
Is it? Alright. Don't you want to change? Why would they? Are you sure? As long as you're here of your own free will. Yes.
Life is prosperous. I'm much happier kissing the many lips of the surface than tending a field or manning a shop.
Based. Alright, anyway. Yeah, I'm not doing this shit. Alright. Ween roll. Whoops. I don't feel like I should be on stage. Monsieur.
Enjoy the fiddling. Throw a few coins our way and let us play on into the night.
Alright, toss a coin to the Witcher. Man literally stops performing. Alright, what about you?
You can stare as much as you like.
Can I? Man, I wonder what would actually happen if I... Can I actually do this? Give me like... You know what, just like 57 coins. Throw them. Wait, hold up. Before I do that, like, in case I hit her. I don't want to start a brawl on accident. Bro. There you go.
That blacksmith was paying me to use the clamping device.
Does that not work? Can I, like, throw it directly at her? I just, like... Yoink the money that I threw at her. Hold up, can I? Wait. Why did you do that? What do you mean, why? Isn't this what you do here? Oops. I drained her strength.
I know my fingering is immaculate. But you can compliment me afterwards.
Huh? What? Alright, I'm out. I'm fucking out. Like, this place is weird as hell. It's sussy as fuck, let me just say that. Alright. Let me go off. I need to figure out the entire fighter slash paladin thing. Like, I guess, like, I don't really need these superiority dice. Because it's like, the sweeping attack is useless. Riposte is good, but I have a feat for that. And feigning attack is usually useless because I need my bonus action for, like, the great weapon attack. And trip attack has a strength save. Which, in case you don't know, my strength is 8. So, like, all of this is just trash. Like, the only good thing it does is the fact that it deals, like, 1 to 8 more damage. Because of the superiority dice. Anyway, I need to find Raphael. Man, this place is fucking huge. It even, like, goes this way. What doesn't make any sense? Well, I guess that's the nymph. I want to go for the nymph. Okay, that's locked. I don't know if I want to just like trespass in the brothel. But like, that sounds like the worst idea ever. I mean, trespassing is usually bad. But this sounds like even worse. Alright. Devil's Den. Like, did they literally just like change the name of this... Just to like suit this guy.
I'm glad you came. Not to my door, not yet, but to the final reckoning.
I'm glad you came.
One more thing before we begin, though.
Snap. What was that? Am I gonna die?
For the first time since the Nautiloid, your mind is clear. It's unsettling.
What the hell just happened? Did you just cure me of the tadpole? What? The tadpole is slumbering and my blood isn't boiling.
I gave you back your privacy by shutting that illithid in your pocket out of your mind. It can't hear us.
Oh, what the fuck? You can do that? I trust the illithid more than I trust you. I'm not scared of that creature, not when Baal himself has hooked his eyes on me.
Oh, calm. It's the reason you're in this predicament. And I'm your only way out of it. Indulge me. And at least hear me out.
I really don't need to get rid of it anymore.
You've impressed me. I wasn't sure you'd make it this far.
I mean, it's been like 500 hours at this point.
You're still on the road to ruin. A road that leads directly to a confrontation with the Elder Brain.
Yeah, I'm just gonna kill it.
It will kill you and everyone else in this city. At worst, it will assimilate you, and you won't have enough free will left to even wish you were dead. You have the key to destroying it in the palm of your hand, though.
Do I? I don't have anything. The Astral Prism. Orpheus.
In a manner of speaking. But it's the one inside the prism that you need. Not the illithid. The Gith. I can give you the means to break him free.
Why would I do that? Orpheus's guards tried to kill me. Why would I want to free him?
I suppose you'd rather suck on the Emperor's tentacles till the end of your days?
I mean, yes. No.
Is your only hope of surviving this horror show without devolving into an illithid?
What do you mean, devolving?
To you, he will be a friend. After all, you're at war with an Elder Brain.
I mean, all the evidence I've seen suggests he's my enemy.
If I'd realized you were so gullible, I'd have tricked you into selling your soul for a pocketful of beans when we first met.
I mean, I probably would have taken it.
You are nothing more than a beast of burden, one that will transport it to the Elder Brain.
How do you even know about the Emperor?
An ox requires food and the occasional beating to keep it moving. You are simpler. The Emperor's words serve as both carrot and stick.
Perhaps it is true that Orpheus would ally with you against the Elder Brain. But if he proves uncooperative once free, you may have to kill him.
I am not. I will not free Orpheus, alright? Why? Okay. I am convinced. Like, okay, here's the deal. If I say I'm convinced, can I still just like not do it? Or is this just like locking me into it? How do I free him?
The Orphic Hammer. An artifact capable of shattering the chains that hold Prince Orpheus is held securely in my House of Hope even now.
Perfect, give it to me. It's very convenient.
Isn't it just? And it's even more convenient that you can give me exactly what I want in return.
And what is that? I suppose you want my soul?
You really do think highly of yourself. My sights are set on something much more valuable than your soul. Succulent, though it would be. I want the crown that dominates the Elder Brain.
Are you fucking serious? Like, you think I am going to give... Like, my man is like, oh my fucking god, why would I do that? Like, why would I ever do that shit? Like, man, I'm too tired to deal with your shit at this point. I'm tempted, but what, huh? Why are you so eager? What exactly is the crown? It'd be insane.
Better to have it in my hands, and far from your precious world, than in the hands of the gods and monsters that fight over this city's soul.
Why would it be better? Why would it be better? But what exactly is the crown?
Ancient and full of wonder. I have craved it ever since the Archwizard Karsus created it long centuries ago and brought doom to the Empire of Netheril.
Okay.
That was the great age of humanity, and Netheril's flying sky cities were the apex of civilization.
Why would anyone need a flying city? Like, what's the point of that?
Entire cities plummeted from the sky like angels. With broken wings.
Cool.
The screams. Oh, the screams. Hundreds of thousands of people watching in horror as the ground came up to meet them. It was not a happy meeting.
You don't say.
And Tarsus like, was responsible.
Can you just...
Not driven by malice, but by ambition. He forged a crown imbued with all the powers of magic. A crown that would make any who wore it a god. Men cannot contain so much power. The crown destroyed its creator, and his empire fell with him. Karsus's folly, the bards and scholars call it. I call it hope. The hope of creating a better world. And the
my dude, I am still not giving you the crown. Like, you can say whatever the fuck you want. It's like, I am going to use it.
Could be the triumph of devils. And that I could use that crown to unite the nine under one archdevil supreme. Me.
Ah, yes. So there's the reason. The idea of you ruling all nine hells doesn't fill me with joy. I think you'd make a fantastic Archdevil Supreme. What makes you think you'd succeed in using the crown? Why didn't you take it? Yeah, I'll take the crown and use its powers myself. Let me just save before I do something irreversible and have to do the entire dialogue again.
Oh, I'm sorry, you were serious? The crown has laid low all who attempt to harness its power. Archwizards, emperors, gods. It would tear you apart.
I mean, why do you care? If it does, then you can just take the damn crown off my dead body, right? Why didn't you take the crown
the
there?
Archdevil Mephistopheles snatched up the crown and squirreled it away in one of his vaults. He's not more than a frigid archivist.
And how the hell...
So much power and potential kept inert. He made a miracle into a museum piece. I raged. But only for a decade or so. Then I waited. Ever watching for more than 1,000 years for a mistake, a mishap, a misadventure. And these chosen who have caused you so much trouble accidentally did me a favor. They brought the crown back into play.
And what? How did... It must really annoy you that some mortals managed to steal the crown when you couldn't. How did they come to have the crown? What makes you so sure I'll get it? Yeah, that's a good question.
Through the aid of a Diabolist, somebody capable of opening a portal to the Hells. Deep in the Hells. They must have raided Mephistopheles' vault. Impressive, I must admit. But they'll be dead soon. If you don't kill them, the Elder Brain will. It doesn't have feelings in the way you'd understand them. But it seems rather angry.
Doesn't it?
It is inevitable. When you destroy the brain, and you will because you must, the crown will be yours for the taking. And when that moment comes, you give the crown to me. In exchange, I give you the hammer now.
A simple transaction, it seems, but it's more than that. He's offering you an alternative to the mind flayer in your head.
I am not taking
it. Take Raphael's deal and you could free Orpheus. With Orpheus free, you would have no need to rely on the Emperor. There's no guarantee that Orpheus would be on your side.
Like, first of all,
if you take the deal, you have to fulfill it. You'll have to deliver the crown of Karsus to the devil himself.
I'm not taking it.
He claims his ambition is to unite the Hells, but can he be trusted to stop there? Do you trust him more than you trust the Emperor?
No. It's like first of all, like, how is freeing Orpheus in any way beneficial to me? Like, if I free Orpheus, wouldn't I just, like, instantly succumb to the Elder Brain? Like, isn't he what's keeping me from all of this bullshit through the artifact or something? Man, I don't get it. I guess not. I agree to deal. I'd rather destroy the crown. No deal, Raphael. I'm leaving.
I won't stop you. But time is running out. So, don't stay away for long. If you see reason, I'll be here, waiting. Right up to the moment the world ends.
My god. But He threw me out of the house. Damn bastard. Alright.
There you are. I thought I'd lost you.
Yeah, don't worry.
Something was blocking me from hearing your thoughts.
It was Raphael.
Raphael? Well, thank you for your honesty. Of course, I should have known the devil would come sniffing. The stench of impending chaos is irresistible to them.
It is,
then
isn't
what
it?
What did he want with you?
Orpheus. That's what he wanted. He knows how to free Orpheus. He wants the crown that's on the brain. Can I just tell you about all of that?
Giving a devil what he wants sounds like a brilliant idea. And what did he offer you in return for bringing it to him?
Means to free Orpheus? Like, I'm not gonna lie to him. I'm on his side.
Tell me, you turned him down.
Of course.
Good. I am glad, but be careful. The devil is like a cockroach. No matter what you do to it, it will always come back.
Pretty much, that's about it.
I doubt this will be the last time you are approached.
Of course.
I trust that you will continue to remember who is really.
Man, you're making it really hard to trust you.
You cannot defeat the Elder Brain. You cannot even get close to it, no matter what the devil whispers in your ear.
I bet I can. I bet I could, to be honest. I feel like I could, but like, it's like, I don't trust either of them. I'm just gonna take the Elder Brain for myself. I'm just playing both of them. I play both sides so I can always stay winning, no matter what. Let me just lockpick this place. Can I lock?
Bet I can crack that open.
All right, that ain't too hard.
I mean, to try.
Okay. Rules of the reading room. A what? I'm not even gonna read that. It's like, why is there a dog collar? Why is there a journal? He's getting the whispers? The fuck? Eon? Did I see someone like that? I don't think I did. Alright, let me go up. Man, what's the point to this? I guess I could just like fly somewhere else. Alright, can I fly with my little eye? Yeah, like right here. To this balcony. Yeah. Don't worry about me, I'm just trespassing. Alright. Lockpick. Man, I'm running out of the thieves' tools. And I even bought like 3 of them. What the fuck? What did I walk into? Am I supposed to be here?
Tell me. Am I beautiful?
No.
More than beautiful. You are the aurora stretched across the north skies. You are the golden dunes.
Why did I walk in here? What is she?
You are the fruit of the forbidden palm. Soft on my skin.
Oh my fucking god.
Sweet on my tongue. You are my sin and salvation.
The only sin here is her face. Don't mind me. Oh.
Your parasite stirs, and you gaze at the nymph through the flaming fist's hungry eyes. Your muscles shiver with her longing. Your skin burns with her heat.
Ah, fuck.
What's wrong, Jara?
What are you? Wait, I know you.
You aren't safe. Get out of here. Mind if I join? This looks personal. I should leave.
I don't understand. What's
your face? The Absolute has shown me.
Can you run away?
What's going on? Who's this man?
Your head screams in agony. The change has come. Pustules boiling beneath your skin, your bones twisting,
what
your
the
flesh
fuck?
Rupturing. And suddenly, silence.
What's happening? Yeah, that's a great question. I think she's turning into a mind flayer. Well, that was quick.
Don't want to draw any attention.
Can you explain to me why this game is so fucking stupid? Like, I just lost my action because I clicked on the enemy before the fight and I didn't even get a hit. Yeah, that makes sense. Anyway. Bonk. Bonk. That was easy. Anyway. You alright?
Hells. I'd heard tales of mind flayers, talons sharp as daggers, and tentacles yet more fearsome.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
But no tale did justice to its ethereal beauty. It floats like a butterfly. Its blood shimmers like silver.
What the fuck are you on about? Thing could kill you and you're musing on its beauty. I thought you'd be more upset. They are beautiful indeed and mostly full. Yeah, I'm gonna raise her up because I am technically like half mind flayer, aren't I? I think
is it not in the Illithid's barbarity that we find its splendor? Your eyes are no less monstrous, I assure you.
What the fuck?
A lesser woman might be frightened, but I am no lesser.
Man, she is a professional, isn't she?
Her gaze intensifies. Your breath quickens, and your heart skips a beat.
Fucking hell.
The woman's senses are heightened, and her fire stoked. The mind flayer is no mere curiosity, but an object of desire.
The creature, huh? That, huh? Well then, I'm glad you're safe. I'm not one to judge, but desiring an extraplanar being like that is peculiar. Yeah, let me just say that.
No desire is peculiar. It is instinct, and instinct never
lies. And she's into some weird shit, isn't she?
But perhaps there are other flavors that might satisfy my palate.
I think I'm in. You know what? Nah, maybe not. Surely. Surely. She's just doing something else. What did you have in mind? You could just give me a few coins instead. Yeah, that would be... You know what? Fuck it. Oh my fucking god. Yeah, this is gonna be
Rapture.
Fucked up.
Close your eyes and listen.
Wait, what a rapture? What the fuck do you mean about that? I think I'll excuse... Imagine just being like, ah yes, let me just leave. Is my character actually gonna get raised up after 200 hours? I don't know about this. Alright, let's go.
You see only darkness. Her voice shines through it, warmer than the sun.
What the fuck?
Yet cooler than night.
Is she a dryad?
Here, there is no suffering.
There is still a dead corpse,
here,
like,
you want
right next
nothing.
To us.
Here, you are anything.
Am
here
I?
In one word, tell me, what will you be?
I'm about to come. Sane, rich, powerful, sane, revered. I think we're done here. That's more than one word, I'm pretty sure. Can I just... There should be an option that's just like Giga Chad.
You are more than powerful. An emperor to emperors. Your head adorned with a crown of gold.
Where did the dead body go?
Ruby. The heavens tremble with the steps of your army. All beasts, all men and women... All creatures of
man,
the
this is some weird shit, isn't it?
Your flesh shivers.
What
your
the
heart
fuck?
Bursts. True ecstasy.
Did I just not?
Fleeting moment.
No.
Open your eyes.
Wait, that's it?
I remember you, and you remember me.
I feel like I've been scammed. My man. He just nodded. Added just like the word of a woman. It is fucked up. So fucking hell. Even in game, it's like what the fuck? Is that it? Is every single scene in this game like that? You know, like a sussy scene. And I expected something more, to be honest. Anyway, there's an admission pass. Let me just yoink that. Nobody seems to care. Why can't I take the brain specimen though? That's weird. If I get her room is literally just ASMR. Like that's about it. And it wasn't even a good one. But can I go in here? I don't think I want to go there. Well, that was this place. I need to get into this Verm's Rock Fortress. I'm not gonna talk to Raphael again. And I need to get to the lower city, which is like, I guess, through here. Can I just fly over here? At least I have the flying. Well, you know what? I think I'm gonna keep going with this. I said I would only play for 2 hours, but like, might as well just continue. I wanna see what actually happens.
To crowd me. There's enough food in this city to feed an army, fist, absolute, or otherwise.
Cool.
Ham, cheese, fruit, veg. Oh,
veg?
Getting something. Oh, what am I forgetting?
Oh yeah, that's the same person that talked before.
I need a quick word. Magically.
Wilson?
Fruit, vegetables, what can I do you for?
What can I, huh? What can you do me for? Wait, what the fuck? He has like 27 potatoes. I could just like take this and have camp supplies for the rest of my life. I already do. I mean,
if you're hungry, you know where to find me.
Under a bridge, I guess.
High class produce,
prices. What about these guys? Well, no, I already talked to those. Can I go down here? Okay, this place is locked. Tight. What is the Raphael's room? Right, I see. I'm gonna just like sneak into this place for no reason. What about you?
I'd love to chat, but I've got a suit to find. Who knew buying something so simple would take the bones of a day?
What is wrong with your face?
You have got to check out Dan Fallon's dancing axe. Their leatherwork is amazing.
Man.
Excuse me, we're discussing Steelwatcher Gyronetics. A topic beyond your understanding, I imagine.
Motherfucking hipsters. Vine Garoon.
Are you a Steelwatcher fan too? If so, we meet here every day to discuss their mechanics.
Well, never mind, it's just nerds,
my
I see.
My mate got thrown by a Steelwatcher. Lucky bugger. The trajectory was perfection.
What the fuck?
Need something? I've got the tools for any job.
Thieves' tools?
Any job.
Wait, does she have thieves' tools? Oh, let's go. I need a lot of those. And they're only for 300 gold. And that's cheap. Holy water. Now you can take that.
Whatever you're working on, hope that fixes it for you.
Yeah, I'm sure it will. Anyway. Let me check this house.
Better not be cursed.
Or shop. And this is just gonna be me. Hello, hi. Almost
pain. Put him up. Put him up.
Wait! I wasn't really gonna fight you. I was just trying something out. My name's Narber. Adventurer to be, soon to be the best adventurer anyone's ever seen.
Yes.
As soon as I figure out what kind of adventurer I want to be. What do you think? Can I be a fighter?
You should be a warlock. I could not give less of a shit. Here's a tip from a real fighter. Why don't you actually fight me and I'll tell you.
Sure. I'll just raise my fists and... it's no use. I can't do it. Guess old Nobber's more of a talker than a fighter. Right you are. I'll just find something to punch, I guess.
What
it
the fuck?
It won't hurt, will it? No, surely not.
Surely. Surely it wouldn't. Just punch the wall. I mean, if you're American, it's not gonna hurt that much. If you're European, you're gonna break your fist. So, better find a good wall.
Hello, stranger. Thanks for stopping by Calm's Garms. I'm Calm. Well, Carmen. What can I do you
Man,
for?
Man, so fucking funny. Anyway, just, you're not... You've not quite got the pair nailed yet, Carmen. It's
like... Ugh. If it's empty patter you want, get your clothes from a brother Figaro. But if it's genuine quality and genuine taste you're after, Calm's Garms as you covered.
Ah, shit. All right. Oh, yeah. He's in danger.
A killer? That's... gods. I've no love from my brother, but that's extreme. He doesn't deserve that.
Yeah, I don't
Thanks
think
for
he does.
Warning me, but it's him that needs warning, and he never listens to me.
So why don't you get on with your... That sounds weird.
You wouldn't either, if you knew him like I did. Since Dad died, he thinks he's cock of the bloody walk, that I should give up my shop and work for family business. For him, dick.
Maybe... Yeah, surely. Let's...
Maybe you should keep your nose out of where it doesn't bloody belong. Now, you want clothes or not? Sounds good.
Let me just look.
Get you something a bit... fresher than your current outfit.
Okay, hold up, hold up. Some of these look pretty damn good. Let me... Wait, so this is... Finally, the time when I can get my transmog. Let me buy a bunch of them. I might actually get a new outfit after... I mean, I got this in Act 1, didn't I? That doesn't look bad. All of these are the same. Alright, let me see all of that. Umber trousers? Wait, does that not have... I'm pretty sure this doesn't have like a chest piece. Alright, let me check.
Remember, come.
And the fly still isn't dead? I haven't seen it for so long I thought it was gone. Alright, let's see it. Sort by type. Why is this a different type? You know what, just give me the latest. So the shoes. I mean, sure. This is a spring slim outfit. I mean, it's not bad. Better than this blood, this piece of shit. Solemnity. Is this fucking... Alright. What's this? Okay, that looks way worse than I thought it would. What about this? Yeah, all of these are just like the same shit except in different colors. Wait, this is literally the outfit that Shadowheart wears, isn't it? Except it's like different color. What's this one? I mean... Man! It's like... The pants look like shit, to be honest. But like, dude... Holy... Can I change the color? Is that possible? It's like this, combine. And not like that. Can you put it on? Like, I swear to God, the dyes in this game are so garbage. It's like...
Welcome back to Calm. Sounds good.
Alright, let me try something else.
Fresher.
What about black? Black and azure. Okay, first of all, just show it to me like this. Two of these. Like, transmog is important, alright? I'm gonna be, like, finishing the game in, like, 2 seconds or something. I might as well look good while I'm doing it. What about black and white? Just pure pink? Pale pink. No custard. I wonder why this one is just like very rare. Black and summer green. Alright, let me just buy the red one too.
Remember.
Okay, let's see it. This? I mean, this is literally just like... I mean, I don't like this one, I'll be honest. It's like this weird thing where it has like this... Yeah, I don't like that. It looks weird. But like between these two... I feel like this one's better. Let me change the color though. Combine. They call it black and azure, but like, this is literally just blue. What about black and furnace? Did that like replace it? No. I have to do like combine. I mean, this looks way better. What is this? Black and furnace red. I don't know why, but I had a sneaking suspicion it would be good. This is just like the black and white, I think. Like, meh, to be honest. What about the pink leaf? Oops, I just put on shoes. Wait, why is this pink and leaf green? It's literally red. But like, okay, these two are kind of good. What about this? Okay, that's awful. Like, anytime I try to get pink, it's just not pink. For some reason. And this is once again just red. I think the black furnace was the best one. You know what? While I'm here, might as well just try out with the ones that I'm not gonna keep anyway. I mean, this is... it's weird, let's just say that. But I think it looks better than before. Now it has like skin color here. So it barely looks like it's covering you with the custard thing. Wait, is that? I think it is. What is this one? I mean, that's alright. I think this one's gonna look good with black and white. Never mind. Maybe? How is it? Like, look at this. Tell me this is black and white. How is this black and white? Like, this is gold and white with red. I mean, like, these things are gold or silver or something. Why is the character so fucking cheeked up? That's my question. Let me combine these two. That's trash. Alright, Lionheart. Combine this with this. Alright, this is the one that I wanted to use. And... let me just combine, equip this, and combine it with this. Let's see what that looks like. Like, man, I don't know. Like, they both look decent, but I feel like I want to, like, I think this is better. Yeah, let's just stick with this one. I'll send these to camp. Just in case. Clown's severed hand. I still have it on me, don't I? And I don't think I'm ever gonna need this. I'm just like drop it on the floor. I can't even sell it because it's quest. Wanna talk now? Anyway. Wait, what?
Roar! 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 Are you scared? Did you wet your pants? Did you?
Is he insane? Pretend to be terrified. You don't know when to shut up. Let me guess, you decided to try being a barbarian.
That's right! You got it! Yay! So how did I do? Are you quaking your boots with fear?
Dude. Let me just pretend to be terrified after I said that. Wait, Rapture? Affected entity has plus 1d6 bonus? Wait, what? Why do I have that? 20. And I wasted a natural 20.
Nobber has found his calling! Roar! Maybe not!
Man, my face is fucked up. What is this Rapture thing? Oh, that's from the Dryad, isn't it? Oh, fucking hell. Well, that's good. I'm chilling then. Alright, let me go up. Garm's Garm. Kobold? Nobody would miss that, right? Surely. You know what? Let me just yoink that.
Skulk about. On my way.
I'm not sure if they're gonna like look for me. Let me fly to the roof. Nobody can get me there. Ah shit, I send the I send the clothes away. Well, I guess I'm not gonna combine it. Just like pointless anyway. Anyway, let me fly here. I think I found the lower city. That gate looks awfully suspicious.
Welcome to Danthelon's Dancing Axe. Don't draw any trouble on old Enthar. He acts like he's up for it, but he's retired for a reason.
What the fuck?
You break it, you... Well... Knowing Enthal, it was already broken.
What the hell?
Not have a word.
Greetings, sir. Your noble bearing brings a little class to my humble establishment. How may I be of service?
Let me see what you have to trade. Wait, hold up, hold up. This looks... Bag full of bags. Oh, this is like the mod. That like adds like all of the different bags. So this is the guy who sells it. Enfarl Danthelon. He's a gold dwarf. Gauntlets of the Warmaster. They have disadvantage on saving throws against your maneuver and weapon actions. But I lose the damage. This is Horns of the Berserker. Plus 2 bonus to attack rolls when attacking creatures that have already taken damage. That doesn't sound bad. Unarmed and melee attacks will deal an extra 2 necrotic damage as long as you don't have your full health. If you don't deal any damage this turn, you take 1 to 4 necrotic damage at the end of your turn? Hold up. That sounds really good, doesn't it? So, like, I'm way more likely to hit. And I deal more damage. But, like, is this, like, an ability or something? That's passive. What the fuck? So, like, am I just gonna keep taking damage all the time? Or probably just in combat, right? Attacking gnomes or dwarves with this weapon receives damage bonus. Supreme Elixir. That sounds real good. I'm gonna take this helmet. Like, don't need... I mean, the constitution saving throw and the bonus to saving throw against spells. It's definitely useful for, like, keeping up the concentration. Oh yeah, this deals damage to me every turn. Doesn't that, like, ruin my concentration? Maybe it does. Yeah, I don't think I want that. What is this? Your unarmed attacks. Nope. At the beginning of the wearer's turn, the cloak activates, granting enemies disadvantage on attack rolls that target the wearer. This effect lasts until the wearer takes damage. What? Isn't it like OP as hell? So like every single time my turn begins, the cloak will activate and give disadvantage on enemy attacks until one of them hits me. Wouldn't this basically be just as good as a permanent darkness? Until I get hit, of course. And then I'm gonna get hit way more. I don't know how that works, but if that works like that, then it's OP as fuck. All of these are just like shit. Garb of the Land of the Sky. While using Patient Defense, you also benefit from the effect of Blade Ward. Huh. Raise. While using Step of the Wind, your next attack roll... Okay, that's like a... This is basically like a monk armor. And it has armor class plus one, what the fuck? Harmonic Dweller. Oh, what the fuck? You make a performance check. Success granting all your melee weapon attacks additional damage equal to your charisma modifier. Like, some of this stuff is, like, really good. But honestly, I'm not gonna buy anything. Like, I don't know how this works. Like, if this could break my concentration, this is the worst helmet in the game. And if it can't break my concentration, then it's, like, insanely good. But, like, I don't know. I feel like I don't want to even try it out. It's, like... Yeah. I'm gonna buy this, though. And a supply pack. Everything else I don't really care about. Cobalt dye is very rare. Is it? Wait, what? Attack plus one? Wait, what is attack plus one? What? Is it like attack rolls plus one? What does that mean? I mean, I lose the damage. But I have a higher chance of hitting my prone attacks. Like, just like knocking someone prone. I would have advantage on that. I mean, is that better than the necrotic damage? And the strength saving throw plus one. I don't know what the attack plus one means. I'll try it out.
Short feather.
Alright, well, I have attack plus one now. Whatever the fuck that's supposed to do. This. Like, can I check like this? This is all 95% anyway. Maybe it's not without? Nope. Okay, hold up. Probably this guy, right? 95? Like, is every single one of them gonna be 95? How is... This guy's 90% with disadvantage. Wait, that's... I mean, that makes sense, doesn't it? Let me walk out of here. This guy.
This armor was such a bargain. We can't return it.
95. Everyone has a 95% chance to hit. I can't test it. Fucking hell. Well, anyway, it doesn't really matter. I'll just use it from now on. I don't know what attack plus one means. I'm actually just gonna fucking Google it. EG3, what does attack plus one mean? Is it just like the attack roll? Okay, yeah, it's just like the attack roll. So like, I have plus 5% chance to hit with this. And the enemies have disadvantage on maneuvers like this. But yeah, they're heightened. I guess it only works on a trip attack, doesn't it? Hmm. Well, anyway. Let me get up.
Such a bargain.
Wait, have I never... Yeah, no, I definitely was there. I haven't been there. What's this guy?
Now here's someone who appreciates the finest. Stop. Inhale through the nose. Hold.
Did I find the weed shop?
Exhale slowly through the mouth. Now you've just sampled some of Baldur's Gate's finest incense. Delicious, no?
Surely. Let me just check something. Or is it already midnight? This doesn't make any sense. Anyway, those are some heady top notes. I've smelled better. Incense? Alright, glorious.
Aren't they just... You clearly have excellent taste. What can I do for you, sir?
Sir? Why the establishment you have?
I must say, I'm rather proud of it. The wood panelling cost a fortune, but it's so worth it for the luxe atmosphere it provides.
Is it? Anyway, we'll do it.
Everything alchemical from potions to poisons. Just do make sure you read the label before quaffing. Mm-hmm.
Quaffing? Oh yeah, let me just quaff some potions. I'll take that. You know what? I'll take that too. That could have been useful a while back. Hmm. Potion of Supreme Healing. Yoink. Man, I'm using up all of my money. I'll be completely fucking poor at the end of this. Hmm, I don't think I want any of this.
Be sure.
Potion Catalog. Okay. Can I just leave through here? I'm curious about this room though. I guess that's just like someone's house. Well, anyway, she mentioned someone, didn't she? But like, where is her brother? If she's here, you know, like the dwarf, and her brother is about to get killed, then I wonder where the fuck he is. The Steel Watchers don't give a fuck about me, apparently. I love how nobody even, like, considers me a criminal after what I did. Like, I just killed a bunch of people at the start of the zone, and nobody seems to give a damn. And this place is fucking huge, isn't it? Yeah, now this is a thumbnail, isn't it? It's like, if only I could hide all of this shit somehow. Can I? No, I don't think I can. Well, anyway. And it's kind of crazy how they make all of this stuff, knowing that most people will never even look at it. Yeah, maybe I should go down there. Like, do you see that? Like, that's a lot of stuff I didn't go through. Like, there's an entire ship there. Maybe I'll go there before I continue.
I got it.
I wonder if I can fly down from here. No way. Can I? I mean, I could probably jump down. I don't think they allow me to fly down. Cannot find path. Jump? I can jump there. Hold up. I don't think I can fly to there, can I? What about there? Imagine they allow me to do this. Oh, what the fuck? Man, that saves me a lot of time, doesn't it? I don't think I can get back up though. Alright, let's check this place out before I go any further. I mean, I'm guessing this is just gonna be like a bit of loot. Maybe like one encounter. I need to figure out how to break my oath as a paladin. This is definitely gonna be...
A couple times you do it.
Trapped. Isn't it? Okay. Wait, it's just broken? Eh. Sure. I hear some... sirens. I bet I'll be surprised.
Just out of view.
You know what? Do I have a potion? Where is it? I had like something. Like an elixir. Then I have something that just like gave me alertness. Nah, I guess not. Well, fresh corpse. Nothing sussy about that. Okay, there's a blast mine.
Keep going.
Can I just, you know what? Fly. Yeah. That makes a lot more sense to go like that. Broken loot. Oh no. Anyway. Any more traps? Wait, that's a fog. It's a duck shaker.
My legs. I can't feel them. Tell the others. Let the boss know.
This man is not long for this world.
Are you sure? End his suffering. What happened here?
Guild. Wanted the cargo.
You hear the blood gurgle in his struggling lungs. His last ounce of strength is spent.
My dude, for someone with a last ounce of strength, it's like he did quite the dramatic death roll or whatever.
Can I go?
He just started spinning. My dude, steam cloud. Alright, I love how they even give me a trap disarm toolkit. Yeah, I can sell that. Surely no trap on top of them. I'm not even going to move. I will just fly.
Decapitated. Still warm.
Man, I guess I'll just go ahead without him. There's a severed arm. Like, there might be a, you know, a part of the clown. Like, I still haven't gotten, like, all of his parts yet. Alright,
that
any more traps?
Ship was at Moonrise Towers, if I'm not mistaken.
Ah, shit. Of course it was. Like, look, there's still the curse. The ghost ship. Charming Lapham. I mean, I should...
Looks like those two are about to fight.
I should definitely just sneak and attack them, but like, I'm gonna do the stupid thing and just walk up to them. I mean, it's a dialogue option, isn't it? Alright, what the fuck do you want?
Nobody messes with the Stone Lord rattling.
Nine Fingers sent her love, asshole. Your Stone Lord's a dead man walking. You, help me kill these asses. The guild will sprinkle you with gold.
For someone who just made, like, the biggest threat in the world, she's immediately like, can you please help me? I could go for some spoils, I mean, this Stone Lord sounds like a better bet. Yeah, I don't know who I want to side with. Like, it seems like there's either, like, the Nine Fingers or the Stone Lord. I guess Nine Fingers is a woman, right? Maybe I can raise her up. Or I can just kill them both. You know, must we really fight? How about I just kill all of you?
This.
No, I don't think I will. Unless my initiative sucks. They're still fighting each other though. There's the old plague guys. Isn't one of these guys on the list? Alright. Let me just, you know, while they're dealing with their shit, I'm just gonna put my darkness somewhere over here. And I'll wait. Do I want this? No. I doubt they can see in the dark, can they? Surely not. I'll use this just in case. Alright, I'm gonna wait my turn. She literally just like threw a bomb under herself, dealt like zero damage.
For the Stone Lord.
Man. What the hell? He's attacking me. Weapon dropped. Okay, it seems like the other side is winning. They have a lot of turns, don't they? My dude, you can't shoot into the darkness, you dumbass. I need to kill this Stone Lord guy. That's for sure. Holy fuck. Yeah, that's gonna work, surely. Wait, does it... Oh, I have a heightened maneuver on this too. So I'm more likely to make people bleed. That's cool. What else? What could I have possibly expected? Anyway, trip attack. And he still didn't manage to fall down. Nice. That's some good AoE, isn't it? So I killed the strongest one on the right side. Now I'm gonna kill like one of the weak ones on the left. Why can't I do an action surge? Did I never short rest after a fight? Who did I even fight? Alright, she's raging. She's doing no damage. Okay, I'm gonna kill this guy. Because right now it's a 3v4. I'm just like trying to... like... while they're fighting, basically all I'm doing is just like evening out the odds. While they're completely ignoring me. And then I'm just gonna finish off whoever's left. What are you aiming at? And that was... cringe. Wait, what? Wait, this is... wait, is she on their side? Okay, I don't know what's going on now. Let me kill her. I mean, she did use...
blood follows me.
She used like a reckless attack, so it's like way easier to hit her. I will do a cleave. Yeah, sure. Man, I wonder why this sweeping attack is so shit. Like, it's a cleave attack, but it only deals damage with the superiority die. Like, why would you ever use that? It's so trash. Man, why is he jumping? Nah, he can cast it. Psionic backlash. And these people are actually so shit. I guess they are level 5, some of them. At least this time he hit someone. Alright. He needs to die. No reason, to be honest. If I kill her, yeah, she also dies. Wait, did she? She didn't, actually. Alright, there's just four shooty boys left. Okay, three of them. Man, I immediately broke his concentration. Well, that's just two of them left. I think I can kill him. Okay, I didn't expect to kill him in one hit. But sure. That's also fine. Well, I killed all of them. And there's a Mind Flayer Parasite. Yoink? Does this do any damage? I don't think it does. I don't think that's good. Yeah, I don't like any of these anymore. Just like, maybe the black hole? You know what? I'll just use the charm thing. Steal everything and... Well, anyway. I mean, it's basically exactly what I guessed it would be. Just like a bunch of enemies, nothing else really happening. Object shines. While the dagger is in the offhand, the wielder gains plus one to bonus armor class. I mean, cool, I guess. That could be better than a shield now that I think about it. Like, I could get my armor class so fucking high right now. If I wanted to. I mean, I'm gonna sell it, at least. How much weight do I have? Yeah, I can't really pick up all of this armor. Even though it's worth a lot. Although maybe I should, anyway. Because like, I'm running out of money. And this fucking fly. You know what? I will, actually. This... What? If only I had, like, a... What are those things called? Like, the swatters? There's, like, the thing that you use to slap a fly. Like, that thing. Eh. Alright. Anyway... This ship has the damn curse all around it. For some reason, it's just called Chasm. Oosh. Well, that's pretty good. But I feel like I'm about to have all of them. Psionic Dominance. I guess I'll take this. I mean, all of these things, they're like actions. I would never use an action to use any of this. It's just like too much. If it was like a bonus action, it would be alright. But not like this. Okay. Anyway, let me go back. Is that it? Yeah, I guess this is just like a cache for... two illicit things. I can teleport back up. Man. Let me get to the... Like, what is this? Is it even the lower city at this point? I think it is. Let me just check it out. Wait, who's that? Oh my fucking god, what do you want?
Happy birthday to you! Happy birthday to you! Happy birthday, dear!
Belle? I should have killed him when I had the chance.
Am I a good bard?
I'd cut out your tongue, but I want to know you've inflicted this misery on the less on the rest of the city. Wait, what? Yeah. All the bards I've met play an instrument.
Oh, I don't have one of those.
He doesn't have balls?
Back to the carving board, then.
What the fuck? Is this guy gonna go all through all of the 12 classes? I hope I can kill him.
No door too unhinged. My tools can
Anyway. This?
You want past? Talk to Ellen.
Okay. Ellen?
Sorry, chum. Can't let you through. Worms Rock's closed for the day.
Is it? See this? I've been invited. Yeah, I have the letter. Investigator Valeria needs me in the lower city.
Valeria? Well, I'm not messing about with a murder inquiry for damn sure. Straight ahead across the bridge. A blind ogre couldn't miss it.
Well, try me. It's like, I can do anything I put my mind to. I could literally just fly over here if I wanted to. I wonder if they would do anything about that. Well, I'm here now. Oh my god. Is he back? What the fuck do you want, man? Please, give me an upgrade or something.
Triumph after triumph. You have excelled in base villainy.
I did.
For he
who fights did you see monsters that?
Should look to it that he himself becomes a monster.
Mm-hmm.
When you gaze long into the abyss also gazes into you.
I'm pretty sure that's not how the quote goes.
You have reached the time of majority, and you shall come into your birthright. But another seeks to disinherit you. Do not let her be your death.
Is this real?
Your father loves you best. You have already made us so proud. Slaughter your line. Become the last of your name. Lord Baal shall have but one chosen.
Me, smiley face. Yeah, don't worry about it. I will slay the shit out of her. Back,
snatches of your story written in the blood of a thousand victims. Years spent in worship of Baal, leading his savage congregation in prayer, sacrifice, and slaughter. You were their master, and he was yours. A cruel master, a dread lord, a devoted father.
Man, I'm pretty good.
All is greater than you could have dreamed.
What is this?
You are a spawn of Baal. His heir. His scion.
Revel. Recall there was another. Revel.
The cruelty of the slayer leaps around within. You are not the last of your name. Not yet.
I will there be another, soon.
The abomination wrapped another. In flesh you saw in the colony. Orin, dear sister, must die by your hand. An offering in Baal's sanctum. Your heart pines for the love of your lord. Today is a wonderful day for murder.
Yeah, this is fucking great. All right.
Halt! We do not know how you gained entry, but your trespass shall not be punished. Lord Gortash has been expecting you.
Has he?
The Watcher's presence fades, but another takes its place. Confident, dominant, commanding.
Greetings, old friend. Orin told me you were on your way here, but I scarcely believed it. Welcome back.
Is that Gortash?
Welcome home. Allow me to formally invite you to my inauguration. Make your way to the ceremonial hall.
All right. Well, that was easy. It's an invitation from Gortash. Okay, I need to find... Wait, where's the... I mean, okay, sure. Yo, what up? Ah, fuck, another quake. Alright, let me save the game. So apparently I am the son of Baal himself. I'm the son of balls.
Without all three stones to control it, it will soon start acting on its own will.
The brain is acting up. Sister?
It's a waiting that's hard. If we could just talk to one of the fists, it would be as clear as day that we're not criminals.
Surely.
Have you heard anything about what it's like in the prisons? Actually, don't tell me. I don't want to know.
I wonder if it's Dark Urge. Oh yeah, it is. 100%. It's like the other characters are not this. Like only the Dark Urge gets this dialogue. I mean,
they say Gortash won't be king, but that pomp upstairs sure sounds like a coronation.
Does it? Yeah, like there was that butler, you know, like the guy who shows up every single time I commit one of those murderous deeds. And he told me that I'm the son of Baal, so that's why I think that's only a Dark Urge thing. I have a teleport here now.
No time to talk. I have clients to brief, and they're as sharp as spoons.
I ain't saying nothing to nobody until I've had my trial.
What the fuck?
Oh, leave it out. I've got a trial coming up, and I need to rememberize my lines.
Rememberize? Remember what?
Let's rehearse this one more
Calm
time.
Down, dear.
All right, let me talk to this person.
This is the armory, not a bloody open house. Fists only. Now clear off.
I like to trade.
Trade? Do I look like a shopkeeper?
Yes.
This equipment isn't for sale. It belongs to the Flaming Fist.
Ah, fuck. Wait, okay, what if I were to pay for, say, a trading license? Either you trade with me or I suggest you start running. Yeah, that sounds pretty good. Is that good enough? Oh yeah, it is. 100%.
Fine. Keep your boots on.
Man, how easy it is to trade, isn't it? Is she actually gonna have anything good? Yeah, no. She doesn't have shit. I guess I'll take her sausage.
That lot of use that hunk of junk was. Keeping me safe, were you? Useless.
Anyway. Can I talk to this guy?
You're a stranger. I don't like strangers.
And I don't like you. Smiley face. Better. Lord, what about this?
Be vigilant.
Okay, so I can go down? I mean, I don't know where to go.
The Flaming Fist don't stand for trouble. So stay out of it, yeah?
Surely. Anyway, I need to speak to like an investigator. I guess I'll just go up. I wonder what's down though. Wait, can I even go up? Okay, never mind. It's like, what the fuck is the purpose of this? It's like the smallest balcony I've ever seen. Oh my god, there's a wooden chest here. Let me go through the passageway. Worms Rock Prison. I cannot teleport out of here. That sucks. He's sleeping.
God is fucked.
Bathed in a 10-day. Eat all the onions.
Ogres are like onions. Listen closely to the guards babbling. Surely I can do this. Man. Even though I have two advantages, it doesn't even matter. I guess it doesn't even matter. It never did.
Not all. Back here again. Cell stinks like an old cabbage. Three bowls of this too.
Huh? Wait, what? Let me just walk in. You know what? I'm not gonna...
Here goes nothing.
Actually, let me just talk to her. Why did I climb up on the crate? Can I just click? Wait, what is this game doing?
The guard is forbidden
attending. Okay, excuse me.
What now? Goodness, how embarrassing. I had a heavy lunch. Welcome to Worms Rock Prison, the fifth nail wee jail. What's your business?
The fist nail, huh? They do what? Prison inspection. Open the door and pray I don't find more sleeping guards. I don't know what was the first thing. Surely not a one. I got two ones.
Well, that was a most unusual of circumstances, being what they are. Hang on, I'll let you through.
Man, that was easy.
Well, in you go. And don't feed the prisoners. Makes them cocky.
Wait, what? Based? I don't think there's anything there. Is there? No, this seems empty. Alright, what about this way? There is a door. Not sure if I want to go in. What about this guy?
On your way.
Alright. At least they don't care about me being here. There's people here, though.
I'm not paid to chat.
No? Well, I am.
Huh?
Stay on my good side, yeah?
No, I don't think I will. Anyway. Is anyone actually here? This damn prison is just fucking empty, isn't it? Wait, hold up. This guy. Hold up.
What do you want?
Not your attitude.
You're the one pestering old men in cages. Now scram with your sourpuss. You're disturbing my sitting time.
What the fuck? Alright, well, I guess this was pointless. I mean, usually the prisons are just there for you to escape them. Eventually. As long as you make a mistake, let's just say. So, nothing here. Okay, so if I go up...
Lord Gortash is expecting you.
Wait, how do I go up?
Please make your way to the audience chamber.
And where is that?
Calm down, dear.
Right?
It won't happen.
It's more than that.
There is a door here.
Lord Gortash is expecting you.
Don't like it.
Please make your way to the audience chamber.
Yeah, I can see. I heard that like several times at this point.
Lord Gortash is expecting you.
My god.
Please make your
look. I'm all for Gortash, but those clankers, they don't sit right with me.
What the fuck did you just call them?
Better than you and without complaining. It is unnerving.
Imagine where we'd be without them. The city would be overrun. They're all that's keeping this cult at bay.
Surely.
There's a point. They make people feel safe, if nothing else.
Ha! You hear this? Tell my friends how safe you feel with those metal giants stamping about.
Very safe. I already killed one. They're just tools. You shouldn't trust them.
You've been reading too many picture books.
Lord Gortash himself is the one pulling their strings. We're all better off for it.
Yeah, surely. Lord Gortash is definitely not gonna fuck us up.
Hush!
Patriarchs are upstairs. Lord Janeth could call for me at any moment.
Man.
Cult army on the march, killer on the loose, and Mistress Durinbold still drags me hither and thither.
And you... Right.
You hear? My lady says Absolute's army's on the march. There's watch.
I'll be honest, none of these people have any good dialogue options. Like, you could literally delete every single one of these bodyguards from the game and nobody
head
would
up,
notice.
Chest out.
Okay.
Lord.
Okay. I'm not even gonna listen to them anymore. This is just a waste of time. Now I see why the game's like 50 hours long in Act 3. I mean, if you talk to every single one of these useless characters, of course it's gonna be 50 hours. Literally none of them say anything. Like, why are they in the game? It makes absolutely no sense.
You're free to explore.
Like, they could have made them like every other refugee, just like, you know, you can't click on them and they're just there. That would make like a lot more sense, wouldn't it? What's this guy?
Master Porter, I've taken the liberty of...
Alright. I thought he might be at least somewhat useful. Let me go... So this is the audience hall. So I'm not gonna go there yet. Alright. Let me walk in here. Okay, there's nothing here. It's just like... sleeping people.
What are you doing in here?
You notice the gnome slip a lockpick into his pocket.
I mean, it was obvious, wasn't
it? You're not a fist. Go on, get out, or I'll wake the others.
Great idea. They can deal with you. Paladin persuasion. I can't go. Yet, I'm waiting on your explanation. I am a paladin now. Alright, leave. What happens if I just leave?
You're harmless. Except if you're a criminal, of course.
I just got 650 XP.
It's more than that.
What the fuck?
The way they look at you.
Wait, that was worth it. I just got 650 XP for doing absolutely nothing. Sure. Cool. Audience hall. Well, I'm here now. Oh my fucking god. I'm gonna perish. Am I supposed to like walk down the aisle? Is this normal?
Stand down, villain. In the name of the Steel Watch, aggressive action will not be tolerated in the presence of the patriarchs of this proud city.
Hmm? I'll keep things peaceful.
The Steel Watch appreciate your cooperation, citizen.
What did I do?
Those patriarchs, but a moment. I must greet a most honored guest. Crawling back from his bloody disgrace, it's my favorite assassin. Gods, you're a sight for sore eyes.
Wait, what?
Orin told me she made a fool of you. And I should have known you wouldn't go down that easy.
I like your tone, but you... but I have amnesia.
Then she didn't lie. The past is lost to you. Let me clear up some mysteries then. We share so much history. You and I initiated this plot. We discussed in depth the failures of our predecessors and how to avoid them. We understood that if we were to unite,
wait,
no one could stand in the way of the dead three.
Is he supposed to be saying all of this?
First, we obtained
in front of all of the people.
Then we enslaved the brain. From there, but a small step to the most successful religious...
They are literally standing behind us. Alright. Ask the Emperor. Is he telling the truth? I bet he is. Yeah, I'm not even gonna ask. What was my role in this plan?
In Baal's name, you set your bloody daggers to cause panic in the streets. Killing in the Absolute's name. You would have carried out that part of the plan had Orin not ruined your hard work.
I mean, I'm
next,
gonna kill
the threat
her.
Threat of the Absolute's monstrous armies formed by Merkel's general, Ketherick Thorne. In such circumstances, people crave strong leaders. Leaders that bring law, order, and protection. Leaders like me, Bane's unyielding hand, author of justice. You are soon to witness the people of Baldur's Gate granting me complete power over them. All out of fear of the Absolute. The faithful will do anything in the name of their god.
Why does he have yellow
teeth? It was all going so well.
Is that...
Until you vanished. Orin informed us that henceforth she would speak for the Temple of Baal. And act on their behalf. But she made a mess of things. Unlike you, she cannot control herself.
Well, I'm gonna kill her. You are mistaken if you think I can control myself. I'm back now. How dare Orin take my place? I'll make her pay. I don't remember a thing, but the plan sounds brilliant.
Good. I can see you're still your old self. When Kethric fell, I feared the worst. That our plans would fail like so many before because of discord among ourselves.
Man, I hate discord.
Now you've returned. We can achieve all of our dreams still. You brought Thorm's Netherstone.
I did.
You know, it takes all three to control the brain. Without Thorm's, it's become vexingly willful. The quakes are a clear warning. If nobody steps in soon, it'll free itself from the authority of the crown. I expect it'll start with turning the Sword Coast's infected. You among them. That prism of yours won't last indefinitely. Next, the grand design. The Mind Flayer Empire reborn. If we're lucky, we'll become slaves. If we're unlucky, well... A bleak prospect.
Ah, shit.
But it's a fate that can be avoided if you and I renew our old partnership. Together, we can still restore authority over the brain.
Man, can you wash your teeth? Like, for fuck's sake. What kind of partnership do you have in mind? I want to avenge myself. I want to strike at Orin. Yeah, like, I honestly don't care about what they do. I need to kill Orin for my dark urge bullshit.
Ousting Orin and helping you reclaim your birthright would be my greatest honor. With Kethric felled, Orin proves treacherous. She craves the Netherstones for her own, desperate to impress Baal. She only cares for blood. And your blood and mine are of particular interest to her.
Does she? I'm not afraid of her. If she wants my blood, she'll have to find me first. Perhaps she and I can be allies. I will bring her to heel.
You've met her assassins. Efficient killers, by all accounts.
Did I?
I know you survived previous encounters, but she won't relent. Orin changes shape faster than you and I change clothes. You know, she's tricked you before.
She did once.
She's targeted me as well. I'm well protected, but she's extremely good
at what
she
does. I bet she's here.
If Orin obtains all three Netherstones, she'll plunge the coast into chaos and paint the city in blood. I can't let that happen. I want to lead this city to glory, not scorch its earth. So I turn to the Scion of Baal. You are his dear prince. He created you to rule.
You show proper respect. Good.
Let's make our pact anew. A divine oath, sworn upon spirit and flesh. I do no harm to you, nor you to me. Furthermore, you'll have nothing to fear from my steel watch while our pact stands. Thorm's stone is yours to keep. When you slay Orin and take her stone, you bring it here. So the three are united once again.
Okay.
Together we rule Faerun as kings. No, more than kings. Gods. We rule as the Absolute.
The urge, the deplorably brutal urge, sickens within you. When you level the world over, that dead world must be yours alone. But first you will rule, then you will ruin.
What do you say? Shall we be allies?
Yeah, definitely.
I can detect no deceit. This alliance could serve us well. And if it does not, well, we need not honor it.
All right. Well, I pledge my solemn oath that I will defeat Orin. Orin betrayed me and you did nothing to to help me then. What has changed? I seem to have trusted you once and it ruined me. I'm not about to repeat. I'll think about it. No promises. To the hells with your pact. Can you trust him? I think I can trust him. I don't think he's saying any lies. All right.
Gortash's eyes blink in a consistent rhythm. He stands calmly, confidently. He fully intends to share his kingdom with you.
Yeah, I don't think he's lying. But, like, I am the Dark Urge. I am going to, like, betray his ass, and then I'm gonna kill everyone in the world. That's gonna be great. I'll think about it. No promises. You did nothing to help me then.
We would not meddle in each other's affairs. This was our agreement. She came to us as Baal's chosen. We are but servants to our lords.
Are we?
Your presence here means your lord sees a purpose for you yet. I tolerated Orin, but I liked you.
Okay, hold up. I will think about it, no promises.
Perhaps a demonstration of why you need my help will motivate you to make the right decision. Your camp is compromised. One among you is an imposter.
Oh my god! There is an imposter among us.
I'd suggest a thorough investigation. You'll find I speak the truth.
Ah, fuck.
The faceless in your camp is like a knife at your throat. Remove it quickly.
Oh,
or any
no.
Alliance between us would be exceedingly short.
It's the little kid, isn't it? How am I supposed to find Orin if she can change her form so easily?
Even horror has a home. Find her nest and slay her there.
All right,
the
I will.
Temple, your old haunt, now reeks of her ichors.
Bald, so she stole my house.
Do you even remember how to find it?
No. Do I? No.
A shame. It's a secret even to me.
Ah, fuck.
You're resourceful. I trust you'll sniff it out. If the trail goes cold, follow the bodies.
Alright, why is the... Surely... Okay. Why is the crown falling?
Not, but it will not follow new orders unless the Netherstones are united to give the command. When it finishes executing its current orders, it will be free to do as it wishes. That will be bad. For everyone. Once it is freed from its shackles, I doubt we'll ever be able to bring it under control again.
All right.
Before you do, come and witness as I make history as the first Archduke of Baldur's Gate.
I mean, he's kind of cool. I mean, I don't mind him, but I will betray him eventually. I mean, I kind of have to. Anyway. I wouldn't dream of missing it. I'm taking you out.
Then we proceed. The patriarchs.
Yeah, let's see it. Probably gonna be a cutscene. Man, he looks evil as hell.
Patriarchs, dearest Raven Guard, I will heed your call. A new chapter begins.
Well, this is the guy who we were supposed to save. Right? And he has like the brain parasite
Enver
in his
Gortash,
eye.
Swearest thou by Baldurin's blade to defend the citizens of Baldur's Gate
it's a Raven Guard.
From enemies within and without?
I swear.
Swearest thou true faith and fealty to the same by word, deed, and decree? So that none may suffer?
I swear.
Gathered guests, grant ye consent?
My dude has like the most evil face in the world. I'm just like standing there, prepared to object, say nothing. Yeah, I'll nod, sure.
Enver Gortash,
why not?
The council appoints you Archduke of Baldur's Gate.
I think this is a great idea.
My friends, the Steel Watch stands ready. Let its blade fall on any who would diminish our city. And you, honored guest, will find me in my office above when you return. Do not come empty-handed.
Okay. I will come full-handed. By the way, Ravenguard?
Truest of souls, bathed in her light.
There is a fleeting connection. Your parasite can...
Have you come to behold the new dawn?
No. Have I? By the gods, what have they made of the city's great hero? Indeed. New dawn? Yeah, I'll just say indeed.
Not just glory. Paradise. Faerun suffers in darkness. Tears abandoned us. Helm's Eye has strayed. But Baldur's Gate will soon burn bright, a beacon to light the heavens.
Is he a paladin?
And it will be Gortash who ignites the final spark.
He's a level 11 paladin. Gortash is just level 9.
As Archduke, my lord,
we prepare an army of our own.
Man, imagine if you actually started fighting here. Like, how the fuck would you beat these guys? I could. Surely. Surely my darkness wouldn't run out by the time they died. Mm-hmm. Yep. Well, anyway. That was all cool and all, right? But it seems I must go from this place. I think I go, like, this way. I mean, I confronted him. Blaze Savora.
Keep those feet moving.
She literally said something else. She said, keep those feet moving, and the subtitles were like, no distractions, please. Man, a lot of boats here. I wonder if I can go there.
Shouldn't have wished to live in more interesting times.
Anyway, I think it's been 4 hours now. Has it? Wait, is this... Can I not go here? Alright, you know what? I feel like this is the perfect time to end it. At least like the episode or whatever. I mean, I'm just about to stumble into the lower city. You know what? Yeah, I feel like that makes sense. Just like before I even go there. Alright, save the game. Verm's Crossing. Save. Quit. Game. Alright. So basically, what's gonna happen is... Tomorrow, which is like technically today, I will be playing Diablo 4. That's like the 1st of September. I think, yeah. The video for YouTube will be out like way later. It's like the video, like YouTube videos are like 1 week ahead or something like that. Maybe like 5 days actually. So that's gonna take a little while. And you know what? Let me just check something.